This episode of D News is brought to you by Harry's. So, it's cold and flu season. That sucks. But whenever I feel crappy, I can't tell if I've got the cold or the flu. Does it even really matter? What's the difference? Howdy, sickos. Trace here for D News. When I get a cough or a headache or whatever for a few days, I always assume that it will go away or that I have a cold. But sometimes it's actually the flu. Even though the medicine says that it's both for cold and flu, they're entirely different viruses. The common cold is caused by over 200 different viruses. Coronaviruses, rhinoviruses, metapneumoviruses, enteroviruses, parainfluenza viruses. They all make the short list, but they really are all different. This is why we can't cure the common cold. The flu, on the other hand, is caused by influenza viruses. All of these are respiratory viruses. They invade the body and they set up shop, causing very similar symptoms, because the human body only has so many ways to fight off a viral infection. When your body is invaded by a virus, chances are you'll get the same symptoms every time. Dry or sore throat, coughing and sneezing, mild fever, congestion, and maybe a headache. It's pretty standard stuff. If it's really bad, you'll get aches and pains in your muscles and exhaustion too. This happens because your body is spending resources fighting off that viral infection. In general, the flu is worse than the common cold. The fever is higher, the aches and the level of exhaustion are more pronounced, and the cough might be more intense. While there's almost no way to tell the difference between the two infections, really, colds do tend to produce a fever less than 101. They affect the throat and cause a runny nose. The flu, however, affects the lungs and the joints, so you're likely to feel more achy than leaky. Telling the difference is one thing, but once you're infected, you only have a couple of days to get treatment. After the first 48 hours, the infection has usually stopped multiplying and is wreaking havoc on your body instead. Regardless, once symptoms start for viral infections, there is no simple cure. Antibiotics will not help because they fight bacteria, not viruses. Taking an antibacterial drug during a viral infection is pointless. In fact, a lot of the remedies for colds and the flu aren't really based on, well, science. Many people take vitamin C like it's going out of style whenever they get sick, but a study from the University of Alberta looked at the results and found there is literally no evidence that it helps. Results suggest that it might help with marathon runners who have compromised immune systems due to exhaustion, but even then, it's minor. I like, personally, to take zinc when I'm starting to feel ill, and science does support that. Zinc is used by the human immune cells as a catalyst, so when you boost the amount of zinc, your immune cells have more to do better. But too much can actually damage your body, so don't over-medicate. In the end, a cold will persist for 10 days, while some flu symptoms will persist for maybe 3 weeks, long after the influenza virus has been eradicated, by the way. If you really want to avoid getting sick, get a flu vaccination. Only 30% of surveyed adults get vaccinated year over year. Flu vaccines are made every year by specialists who use massive data sets to predict which influenza viruses will dominate the next season. See, there's more than one mutation of the influenza virus, and they vie for power and bodies to infect. The 2014 flu vaccine will protect against influenza A, H1N1, and H3N2, as well as a couple of influenza B viruses. You might recognize the name H1N1. We're still seeing that left over from 2009's unexpected flu epidemic. Pretty crazy, right? So yes, there is a difference between colds and the flu. But if you catch one of the over 200 viruses that cause the crappy feelings, the best way to handle it is to drink fluids and help keep yourself hydrated and to rest. If you minimize nutritional strain on your immune system by enjoying warm chicken soup and letting your immune system do its work, you will be fine. Empathy can also help. Studies have shown people who have families or even an empathetic doctor recover faster than those who don't. So help out a friend if they're sick, but don't catch it yourself. If you insist on medication, decongestants and antihistamines will treat the symptoms of both cold and flu. But again, don't take antibacterial medication unless you know it's a bacterial infection, because it won't help. Viruses don't respond to that. That's something a doctor can tell you, by the way. And speaking of stuff that you keep in the medicine cabinet, if you're looking for a good razor to shave with, try Harry's. Harry's was started by a couple of guys who liked shaving so much they bought a razor factory to make their own blades. Harry's is cheap, they show up at your door, and they're sharp in both look and, well, sharpness. Just go to harrys.com and use the promo code DNEWS to save $5 off your first order, and it'll help support our show. Thanks for watching, everybody. What do you guys think? When was the last time you got the flu? Any home remedies that helped out? Let us know down in the comments, and make sure you subscribe for more DNEWS.